5:39, we're on time. Okay, West Avenue. Like a maintenance away facility. Manual black signal territory now. There are no cab signals on this stretch of track from Patchogue to near Babylon. Practices, whenever you approach a distance signal or a home signal on non-cab signal equipped territory, or if you approach an intermediate signal with a less than clear aspect, it has to be called out over the radio, over the PA system. I got a much clearer picture about how that works in non-cab signal equipped territory. Here. It's the old Blue Point Station. There's Blue Point Avenue. Station used to be. Seem to be calling out the signals on the PA system. Approaching Y interlock and we pick up our second track. leaving Sayville. This train is kind of tired. I think they have to report to Spionk like 2:30 in the morning. And then they deadhead this equipment to Southampton and they bring it to New York and West Side Yard. And I believe they deadhead back to Spionk. We get to Spionk about a little before 10. This guy's running pretty fast. West of Babylon, he'll run even faster. to not disturb other commuters. It's getting a little more crowded.
Thank you.
next end of Babylon, you should be arriving on track 2 with a clear signal. Copeg. Thank you. there's room for 14 MU cars. Of the village of Oceanside before we go back up again. Yeah, right about here is Oceanside. Station. train land. And the Long Beach branch is joining up with us. Station. And we're pacing a train out of Long Beach. Some engineers, this is where they switch to electric mode. Just joined up with the West Hempstead branch on the right. Coming in on the left is the Far Rockaway branch. There was Valley Tower, still an active interlocking tower. Valley Stream Station. Two tracks on the far end are the Atlantic branch that starts at Valley. Seems a lot later than 6:30 in the morning with the sunlight. That's Rosedale Station. Leaves us here. Over there is Laurelton Station. area here where the track divides, where the old Springfield Garden Station used to be. Station. I know of a famous Metro North conductor who lives here. train is one of five dual-mode power trains into New York in the morning rush. 2737 from Spionk is the other one. And you have two trains from Port Jefferson and one from Oyster Bay. Station, New York. Car is thinned out a little bit, so back to talking again. still revving up in diesel mode, you'll probably change around Harold Interlocking. Station. Lost our ventilation. HEP seems to have gone off. Went back on and the lights. I think he just switched over to E mode here. Forest Hill Station. Def definitely sounds a lot quieter up there. These engines run rough on third rail gaps in E mode. Sort of has a split personality. It's a local from Southampton to Babylon and then runs like hell from Babylon to New York. Expressway. Dual mode locomotives are the brainchild of the FL9ACs that ran on the railroad back in the 90s. They ran on train 660, New York to Port Jeff. I think they ran on 603 out of Port Jeff to New York. This is wood interlocking. Woodside Station, the Port Washington branch joined up with us just east of here, and they have their two tracks with their own platforms to the right of us. Central. That should be open by the end of the year, they promise. There's one of the tunnel entrances for the east side access. Electric mode, when you go through third rail gaps, you lose power for a little bit. But in diesel mode, you get a constant supply of power from the prime mover. So that doesn't happen. Through line 2 tunnel. Notice how the ventilators go on and off, they're back on again. That doesn't happen when it's in diesel mode. Tracks down below are leaves that come out of Sunnyside Yard. Used by Amtrak and New Jersey Transit trains. Tunnel. We're following somebody. guy's not even sounding his horn entering the tunnel. They're supposed to do that. He's been taking shortcuts.
We're now approaching Penn Station, our final stop. Please take this time to look around, gather your personal belongings, check the overhead racks, and don't leave anything behind. Watch your step as you exit. Be careful of the gap between the train and the station platform. We'll be arriving momentarily. We'll be arriving on track 20 here at Penn Station, 20 track. We're almost exited. The train takes no passengers. It's going to New York.
It's not going to Philadelphia. Interesting ride. You know, this train could conceivably go to Philadelphia because there's third rail that goes all the way to the outside of the Hudson River tunnels, and it can switch back to diesel. Late, but still a pretty fast ride from Babylon. Good trip from West Hampton. I'll cool my heels here for 45 minutes and then I'll catch a train to Babylon with a connection to West Hampton. I should be back to West Hampton before 10. Got the signal to head into West Side Yard. Okay, moved over to track 19 where I get a much better view of him heading to West Side Yard. Arriving from Oyster Bay. Those 2791's equipment to West Side, you heard him, starting his diesels. That's common practice, I hear, because of those third rail gaps. Trains are in danger of getting stuck, and you got a steep grade climbing up into West Side Yard. Let's see if this guy does the same thing. Well, he's definitely still in E mode. He's shooting up sparks like crazy. That's 505 heading into the yard. 605 from Port Jefferson to around now, but he's running late. I don't know if I'll get to see him.